Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. This fact is hardly known to any because Christianity or Sikhism, they are not cheap. In Christianity, one in a thousand and two in 10,000 will know gospel. In Sikhism, one in a million will know a gospel because people are greedy. Misuse of Holy Spirit is common. Your heart says, you know, this is wrong, but you will do it. So people who are righteous, they go by their heart, by the Christ sitting inside the temple of God. This is the temple of God. Christ is inside me, not outside. Yes, Christ is the royal priest of the God inside my heart. God is inside me, not outside. Outside were Elohim, which were demiurge, not real. This is real because he is sitting in the living temple. This temple is living, not made of brick and mortar, which is dead. Dead God lives in the dead temples, or icons they make of him, you know. All these are dead gods. Here I'm doing an exposition of Acts 20:6-16. But we sailed from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread, and in 5 days we joined them in Troas, where we stayed for 7 days. On the first day of the week, when we met to break bread, Paul was holding a discussion with them, since he intended to leave the next day. He continued speaking until midnight. There were many lamps in the room upstairs where we were meeting. A young man named Eutychus, who was sitting in the window, began to sink off into a deep sleep while Paul talked still longer. Overcome by sleep, he fell to the ground, three floors below, and was picked up dead. But Paul went down and, bending over him, took him in his arms. You know, in Paul, apostle, because his soul has merged with God. Because in the family of God, we have God our Father, Holy Spirit is our mother, and we are the sons. In flesh, we may be male or female, because the Son represents the Father. So Paul, being part of the family of God, as Christ Jesus was, and so the apostles at Pentecost, when they were rewarded with Holy Spirit, they became the twin brethren of Jesus. Saint Paul was twin brethren of Jesus. So what Jesus could do, or what our Father could do, they could do. So Paul, you know, when he lifted it in his arms, mean he has accepted him and intercepted in life. So from dead in letters, he picked him up and made him alive in spirit. Then Paul went upstairs, and after he had, bending over him, took him in his arms and said, "Do not be alarmed, for his life is in him." That means whatever comes from the mouth of apostle, they are non-erring. It comes true because they have the power of our supernatural Father. So whatever came from the mouth of Jesus, he stopped the storm and he healed the people for their faith. Same, this man had faith. That's why he came to listen to Paul. So he died, but he was made alive because Paul had picked him up and asked him to join the family of God. Then Paul went upstairs, and after he had broken bread and eaten, he continued to converse with them until dawn. Then he left. Meanwhile, they had taken the boy away alive and were not a little comforted. We went ahead to the ship and set sail for Assos, intending to take Paul on board there. For he had made his arrangements, intending to go by land himself. When he met us in the Assos, we took him on board and went to Mitylene. We sailed from there, and on the following day we arrived opposite Chios. The next day we touched at Samos, and the day after we came to Miletus. For Paul had decided to sail past Ephesus so that he might not have spent time in Asia. He was eager to be in Jerusalem, if possible, on the day of Pentecost. Remember that people of the East, they were more enlightened. The greater the light, the greater the misuse. So they were more satanic people. For example, people of Kashmir used to be called Guru Brahman. Guru Brahman means top quality, knowledgeable people. And today, opposite, they are top quality sons of Satan. The highest order of the sons of Satan hail from Kashmir. So these Ayatollah Khomeini hail from Kashmir. And you can see what he did, toppled the king away. So beware of these antichrist in churches and in mosques and in Sikh temples. They cannot give your account to God, like Radha Swami and other people, you know, who are leaders, and they have formed their own cults. They are antichrist. One God, one faith. Our Father God blesses you.